excited to start our Christmas program today, our first ever K-12 music program. I hope you brought your Skippy bags. First of all, I'd like to thank Mr. Leonard Broderlo. He's donated cookies for everyone after the program and for the children also participating. So thank you, Mr. Broderlo. And we'll forever thank Mrs. Renee Hibbert for coming and playing whatever we decide to sing in whatever order. So thank you, Renee. And a quick thank you to Carol McIntosh, who is kind of the backbone of keeping us all together. So thank you, Carol. The two youngest girls looked alike, from the tip of their toes to the top of their curls.
They danced, they dressed, they walked the same. In fact, if he wasn't careful, he'd call them the wrong name.
This kind of gentleman's different was for young in the first sentence, who tried their very best.
To milk the cows, feed the chickens and pigs, and to provide food for a family this big. There was Jack and Zach with Will and Bill. They worked hard each day, each tummy to fill. Old Isaac loved each child, so please make no mistake when he soon realized he had a decision to make. For his pockets were empty, he had not a cent. His legs were feeble, his back was all bent. He needed to send off his daughters and sons to work someplace else to raise enough funds. To purchase a gift, a small bundle of food to keep them in a jolly Christmas mood.
Some would go to the mountains, to the top of the hills. Some would go to the city with his noises and his thrills.
But before they left, they took one last chance to join together in a festival dance.
Thank you.
together for Christmas again. And when they met again, they would compare the city and country traditions they shared.
Now Sally and Callie faced the hardest part, for they had never lived far apart.
But Sally longed to see the colorful city lights, while Callie chose the stars and the country nights.
So with a shrug, and a hug, and a clap of their hands, they all went off to explore their new lands.
I love the mountains, I love the roads.
In the city, they danced to Jingle Bells too, but they did the rock and roll version without any shoes.
Just watch as they swing to the Jingle Bells rock, a whirling and twirling while wearing their socks.
Thank you. There's shops, people, and parties not to miss. I see people from countries far, far away to celebrate this bright Christmas day.
Above all the hustle and bustle, the excitement and the noise, you can still hear the ring of the sweet Christmas joys.
Thank you.
children of the city were amazed to find shelves filled with candy and toys of every kind.
Thank you. country kids gathered in the stable, so cold to go caroling to neighbors in the snow.
Thank you.
jolly old Saint Nick and his 8 amazing reindeer who fly so quick.
Thank you.
The country kids stomped and clapped their hands, for they love to dance to any kind of band.
Celebrate while they were still being paid.
Those country folks can really feel the beat in their toes as they dance to the rhythm of the sticks on the roads.
Thank you.
guides and lowly shepherds.
Yes, the music of the city and the music of the country praise the birth of a baby, both special and holy.
Thank you.
Soon the younger sisters couldn't bear it no longer. They had to see each other along with their father.
So they convinced the other children to gather up their gifts and travel back home to the place where they lived.
City and people out of town may celebrate Christmas in many different ways.
But they all gather together to sing songs of praise to the wee baby born in Bethlehem style, the baby called Jesus, who is the Savior of them all.
Yes, Papa, it's so great to be home with the family we love.
To give praise to the child that came from above.
As we gather around the Christmas season, hopefully we'll all remember the real Christmas reason.
Christmas in kindness and thinking of others, such as neighbors and friends with sisters and brothers.
Thank you. We'd like to thank Mrs. Sneeze and all she does for the whole other community. Let's give it up.